हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आवर टुडेज टॉपिक दैट इज़ बेसिक सिग्नल्स। अप टिल नाउ वी हैव कवर्ड द फंडामेंटल ऑफ सिग्नल्स, मीन्स डेफिनेशंस ऑफ सिग्नल एंड सिस्टम एंड एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ सिग्नल्स। देन वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिफाइंड द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ सिग्नल्स। सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट बिहेवियर दे ऑल आर क्लासिफाइड लाइक पीरियोडिक, नॉन पीरियोडिक, रैंडम, देन कोजल, नॉन कोजल, ओके, ऑड इवन। ओके, सो क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ सिग्नल हैज़ बीन डन। नाउ इन दिस सेशन वी विल सी सम बेसिक स्टैंडर्ड सिग्नल्स। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद दैट। फर्स्ट सिग्नल दैट इज़ अ डीसी सिग्नल्स। ओके, सो मोस्टली वी आर अवेयर विद दिस डीसी सिस्टम और डीसी सिग्नल्स। सो इन डीसी वी नो दैट आउटपुट line that is a DC, constant DC we got. Okay, so in DC a constant signals simply take a constant value. Okay, so for continuous time it is represented by ST. Here I have chosen ST, not XT, but is a ST, not XT. You can take XT and that is equal to 1. So amplitude of 1 you got at output side, mean DC having amplitude of 1 you got. So here you can see that the amplitude of 5, here it's given ST equal to 5. So you got amplitude of 5 or 5 voltage or whatever the parameter is there, you got a 5 volt DC. Okay, so XT equal to 1. In discrete time it would be a SN. So yeah, here it's a T, but here is a N. Discrete form is that we have already know now. Okay, so here in example I have chosen that XN that is equal to 4. So I got the signal up to 4. Okay, so 4 here you can see, okay, value of 4. Okay, so here if you choose 5 then you got 5. Okay, up to 5. Okay, so this is a continuous DC signal and it's a discrete DC signals. Okay, so now we're clear with that, and the standard equation for this these two, okay, SN equal to 1 and for continuous ST equal to 1. You can choose X instead of S. Okay, so if someone say define the DC signal, okay, so you can draw. If you have to ask that it's a continuous or discrete, if it is continuous then this is that, and for discrete this is. Okay, so now the second is a unit step signal. First is a DC signal, then second is a unit step. Now the unit step signals, in unit step also for referred as a Heaviside's functions. Literally, basically unit step we are using for a 010101 output. Okay, so it has a zero value until a zero time, at which the point is abruptly a switch to a one. So basic principle or basic logic behind the unit step is this. Now for continuous, if signal is UT, now normally unit step is defined by UT, not XT, but mostly it is given as a UT. So the value of UT equal to 0, uski value 0 rahi, kab, jab time is less than 0. Jab tak time ki value 0 hai aur less than 0 hai, uski value kya rahegi 0. So here you can see, here the value is 0. So up till now the output is 0, remains 0. But if t is greater than 0, you got some output, and here it's a 1, say. So for a greater than 0 you got some output that is 1. Okay, so this is the logic of continuous unit step. UT equal to 0 for t less than 0 and equal to 1 for t greater than 0, and the behavior is like this. Behavior will be like this. Okay, so here you got 0, then as the value of time is greater than 0 then you got some output. Okay, so up to 0 you got 0 and then you got Same thing for the discrete time. So in discrete you go in the form of some sampling way. So un equal to 0 for n less than, here t is there, here n, discrete form n is there. So n less than 0, n less than 0. Okay, this is, and you got output when the n is greater than or equal to 0. So you get this out. Up till 0 you got this, and after 0 you got this out. Okay, so if I put here 4, so I got output having a amplitude that is 4. Okay, so this is a unit step signal. I hope you have clear with this unit step. Okay, now let's say in unit step again. Now here, if instead of ut I put u in bracket t minus some value, if some delay I have provide, then what will be there? If I have provide the delay of, let's say, ut minus 2, so it will start from this, from 2. If I will provide the delay of 2, if I write ut minus 2, the value is we can say 0 for t less than 1, and then it's a 1 for t greater than that value. Then I got the output from this, okay, and that we have seen here. Okay, so here that is shown. Okay, sorry, not this, this one. Here it is shown. Okay, here I have shown. Okay, for continuous time, ut minus tau, and the value of tau be like this, t less than tau and t greater than tau. I want, so output start from here, not from 0. Some delay of here, the value of tau equal to 2. I have chosen 2. So it will be starting from 2 only. Okay, 2 se start hoga. Okay, so some delay, advance delay is there. Okay, yahan se start hoga, not 0 se start hoga, but yahan se start hoga. Same thing for the discrete value, un, where put the value of here n, n ki value yahan jo bhi 2 rakhi hui hai. Okay, so some delay, or sometime it's known as shifting property. Okay, and that we will see in next session. Then we have a third signal, that is a impulse signal. Now the property of impulse say that the output value of the signal, that is 1 only when the for the zero value kab milega, jab time ki value 0 hogi, and for remaining 1 आउटपुट ज़ीरो मिलेगा. टाइम की बाकी की वैल्यू के लिए आपको क्या मिलेगा? ज़ीरो मिलेगा. जब टाइम की वैल्यू ज़ीरो होगी तभी आपको आउटपुट मिलेगा. और बाकी पॉजिटिव वैल्यू है टाइम की, 2 है, 3 है, 4 है, या नेगेटिव है, -2, -3 है, -4, आउटपुट विल बी ज़ीरो. सो दैट इम्पल्स इज समटाइम नोन एज अ डेल्टा. सो दैट्स वाई डेल्टा टी इज गिवन एज अ डेल्टा टी इक्वल टू इन्फिनिटी, नॉट इन्फिनिटी. वी कैन से सम वैल्यू दैट इज इक्वल टू 1, दैट इज ट्रू. If you put the infinitive, that is equal to 1. So delta t equal to here 1 for t equal to 0, and the 0 for remaining value. Agar t ki value 0 nahi hai to baki ke time output 0 rahega. T ki value jab 0 hai tabhi I got some output. This is for a continuous signal, and this is for the discrete signals, when here delta n, not delta t, but is the delta n instead of t, I have written n. Okay, so I got output here. So this is the property of impulse signal. Okay, we can say. Okay. Then we have some standard waveform, that is a sinusoidal waveform. Okay, so for that we know that V equal to Vm sin omega, and as electrical student we know V equal to Vm sin omega t. So I got some output like in the form of some sinusoidal voltage where Vm is the maximum value of that. So here I have choose cosine. You can choose sine as well as cosine. Okay, because minor difference is there between cosine wave and sine and wave. So here I have put some cosine value that is in the form of sine. So I got some standard output. You know that if the your equation be like this, cos omega t plus y or sine omega t. So you got some output like this. Okay. This is for a continuous, and for the discrete you got some like this. So this is in the form of some discrete value, okay, instantaneous value. You can here write also sine omega t. Okay, आप omega t भी लिख सकते हो. यहाँ cos omega t plus 5 लिखा हुआ है. Okay, and that waveform is a standard waveform, sine waveform and cosine waveform. Okay. So that if someone say draw the sinusoidal signal, we can directly draw like this, and cosine somewhere delay is there. Okay, so that we know an equation for this, for a continuous and for discrete. Okay, I hope clear with that. Then we have some exponential graph is there. So exponential graph or exponential signals, this is the equation that we know. Here ht is the given, but some book xt is given, xt equal to e raised to alpha t, or sometime it's given e raised to minus alpha t. Okay, so here alpha t value is this is a standard. You put the value of alpha here with respect to t. Okay, you got this or this waveform. If your alpha is what we can say negative form, you got this type of waveform. If alpha is positive, you got this type of exponential graph. Okay, if negative value is there, then you got exponential graph. But what is the equation? This is the equation. ST equal to, or XT equal to e raised to alpha t, e raised to alpha t. Okay, so this is a exponential graph for a continuous. Same way here, e raised to alpha t is the, if you put e raised to alpha n, Sn equal to e raised to alpha n, then it's a discrete form ho jayega, wo discrete form mein ho jayega. Okay, so if e raised to alpha n is there, then the output will be in the form of some discrete form. The value of n here, alpha, or here I have chosen a, so that a is less than or greater than, accordingly you got, okay, output. And you can get this type of waveform, exponential waveform that we know. Kab mil raha hai for this equation only. They are the standard signals. Okay, basic signals, standard signals. Okay. Okay, then we have a rectangle pulse is there, or sometime is known as a unit pulse is there. Okay. So for that we have a logic that for continuous that is equal to rect as a function t by capital T, where capital T is a to time period we can say, and that is equal to 1 for t less than t by 2. Here I have choose random value t by 2. Okay, so half value I have chosen, so I got half waveform be like this. Okay, yeah, total minus 2 se 2 mein ho raha hai, to half mein mujhe mil rahega, half portion mein, aadha is tarah, aadha is tarah. Okay, because I have chosen t by 2. Okay, same thing for the discrete value, same thing for the discrete value. Okay, n upon here t is there, here n is the number is there, because discrete form is there. Okay, then we have a ramp signal. So ramp signal normally known as a linear signal sometimes, because the logic behind that is you can write ramp t equal to t. You got output t for t greater than t. Agar t ki value obvious greater than mein hi milega aapko output, less than t ki value, agar t is less than 0 to output nahi mil raha hai. Okay, 0 milega. So that is this. तो आउटपुट कब मिलेगा, आउटपुट कब कब और क्या मिल रहा है, आउटपुट मिलेगा व्हेन टी इज़ ग्रेटर देन ज़ीरो, और वो क्या मिलेगा, टी की वैल्यू जितना ही मिलेगा। अगर टी की वैल्यू यहाँ मैंने 1 ले ली है तो आउटपुट 1 मिलेगा। सो फॉर 1 इट्स अ 1, टी की वैल्यू 2 है तो आउटपुट 2, देन टी की वैल्यू 3 है देन आउटपुट 3, 4। ओके, सो लीनियरली इंक्रीज होता रहेगा। ओके, ये लॉजिक डिफाइंड होगा फॉर द रैंप सिग्नल। ओके, सेम थिंग फॉर द डिस्क्रीट फॉर्म। हियर t is there, here n is there. Okay, so you got output like this. Logic remains same here. N की वैल्यू ग्रेटर देन होगा तभी मिलेगा, और क्या मिलेगा, जितनी n की वैल्यू उतना ही मिलेगा। अगर 1 इज देयर तो 1 मिलेगा, 0 है तो 0 मिलेगा, 4 है तो 4, 8 है तो 8, 9 है तो 9. So you got again linear form, but it's a discrete form and it's a continuous form. Okay, so this is a ramp signal. इसे हम ramp signal बोलते हैं. Okay. So these are the some basic signals. Then we have a signum function or signal is there. Okay, this is that. Okay, and the logic uska is tarah hai. So the output we got that is in the form of negative and positive amplitude. Negative amplitude bhi milta hai, positive. Negative and positive both amplitude we got. So if t is greater than 0 hoga to hume positive amplitude mil raha hai. T लेस देन जीरो है, नेगेटिव है तो आई गोट नेगेटिव आउटपुट। सो फॉर पॉजिटिव आई गोट पॉजिटिव एंड फॉर नेगेटिव आई गोट नेगेटिव एम्पलीट्यूड। ओके, सो इन द लॉजिक बिहाइंड दैट इज दिस सेगमेंट टी इक्वल टू 1 फॉर टी ग्रेटर देन जीरो। टी की वैल्यू 0 से ज़्यादा है तो हमें 1 मिलेगा, अगर टी की वैल्यू 0 ही है तो हमें आउटपुट 0 मिल रहा है, एंड टी की वैल्यू लेस देन 0 है तो माइनस मिल रहा है। ओके, सो this is the logic behind singum function. Okay, and then some more signals are there, numbers of signals, standard signals are there, but we have chosen some mostly used signals. Then sin C function is there. Some standard formula for this is this: if you put the value of t here, you got output like this. Okay. And same way we have a triangle signal is there. You can draw the rectangle signal, square signals. Okay, numbers of standard signals are there, and logic of that are there. Okay, this is for a continuous, this is discrete form. This is the standard equation. Now if you put here the value of capital T, total time period is 5. Here it is given 5. Okay. सो यू गॉट आउटपुट लाइक दिस। अगर मैंने 6 रखा है तो ये ज़्यादा आगे जाएगा, 7 रखा है तो ये इस तरह हो जाएगा। ओके, बट एम्पलीट्यूड, अगर ये एम्पलीट्यूड चेंज करना है तो ये की वैल्यू चेंज करो, ये की वैल्यू चेंज करोगे तो आई गॉट अकॉर्डिंगली आउटपुट ट्राइंगल सिग्नल्स। सो दिस इज द लॉजिक, सॉरी दिस इज द लॉजिक बिहाइंड दिस, एंड आई हैव ड्रॉ फॉर सम वैल्यू ट्राइंगल सिग्नल। ओके, सो दीज आर सम स्टैंडर्ड सिग्नल्स नॉर्मली यूज इन सिग्नल एंड सिस्टम्स। ओके, व्हेन यू गो फॉर सम प्रॉपर्टीज ओके ऑफ द सिग्नल एंड सिस्टम, वी विल यूज दिस सिग्नल्स मोस्टली। एडिशनल, एडिशन, सब्सट्रैक्शन, मल्टीप्लीकेशन, शिफ्टिंग प्रॉपर्टीज, देन डिले प्रॉपर्टीज देर। ओके, सो एट दैट टाइम वी विल यूज दिस टाइप ऑफ सिग्नल्स, सम एग्जाम्पल्स विल बी देर। ओके, ओके, सो एट दैट टाइम वी विल सी दिस ऑल दिस एग्जाम्पल सिग्नल्स। सो यू मस्ट नो द बेसिक फार्मूला ऑफ दिस सिग्नल्स, कि भाई अगर डी सी सिग्नल्स है तो उसका फार्मूला क्या है, अब यूनिट स्टेप है तो उसका फार्मूला क्या है। ओके, देन इम्पल्स फंक्शन है, इम्पल्स सिग्नल है, उसका फार्मूला क्या है सिग्नल्स का। ओके, साइनोसोडियल का क्या है, ओके, ट्राइंगल का क्या है, यूनिट स्टेप का क्या है, यूनिट रैंप का क्या है, ओके, सेगमेंट का क्या है। ओके, सो यू मस्ट नो ऑल दिस थिंग्स। ओके, सो हियर आई थिंक वी आई हैव एंड दिस सेशन। ओके, सो लास्टली वी यू हैव अ असाइनमेंट, सो जस्ट सी द एग्जाम्पल्स दैट इज रिलेटेड विद अ सेशन that we have completed. Then explain the step and ramp signal with CT and DT, explain the sinusoidal exponential signals, okay, explain the impulse and rectangular signals, okay, okay, and then you have to follow the obvious instruction, ओके इंस्ट्रक्शन फॉलो करके एंड अकॉर्डिंगली सबमिट करवाना है आपको विद इन टाइम. ओके सो आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द थिंग्स. ओके सो थैंक यू वेरी मच.